our dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 42 in our series, Dice, the Universe, and Everything. I mean, create a RubyGem, nerd dice. So in our previous video, we went and wrote the failing specs for the DiceSet class. We'll leave that in progress in case we need to adjust it. And we'll leave both of these in progress while we do the next few iterations of what we're going to do for the dice set, but let's start now to implement the dice set class. So if we go and try to run this, we will get a failure because we've got an uninitialized constant. We did this with die, so we'll do something similar here. Create our new file. All right, and I'll, at the beginning this time, I'll add the dice set comment, so I'll pause and write that. So I've got my basic class level comment, so it's kind of a combination between what we had with die and the method comment for total dice. I also noted that I left out the damage type, so I put that in the die class comment as well. So now we should have a new failure if we try to run the spec. Still need to require it. So go to nerd dice. Require it. Now we've got all failures. So we haven't written our constructor yet, so that's expected. So we will go and do that with our dice set, similar to die. We'll have a so same method signature you can see as nerd dice, total dice, number of sides, number of dice equals one, double splat options. So now we'll get different errors. Well, we'll focus on one use case so that we don't. Let's close some of these additional tabs. So we'll focus on our simplest option right here, which is line 16. So they're all failing. Got undefined methods on each of these, so let's get going. So we'll have, similarly, our attribute readers nice randomization technique, which we're just going to, so this is an option for future refactoring, randomization technique equals, and that can be a mix-in that we include in both classes because it's going to be the exact same logic there, so there's no need to repeat it, but for right now we'll copy and paste. And then these will remain attribute accessors. In our and that'll potentially make some of our specs pass already. Yeah, four of them are already passing. So we'll implement the other items that we need. So going to be exactly the same as what we have in the item. So now we should be down, I think, to just the one failure in our first block here. Nope, still got three. Oh, because we're undefined method dice. Total we haven't implemented, and then the dice property. So where we expect to be. Now we would want to each going to be an attribute reader. Number of dice dot times dice. Sides, and then you want don't think it'll hurt to just do it this way. We'll find out. So there will be additional ones like the bonus that would get passed to the die class that wouldn't apply, but our initialize method isn't going to care, really. So this might just work. Unexpected constant. Let's look at how we used dot times in our total dice method. Dot times do. Number of dice dot times do dice. We have to namespace it. Unexpected constant, line 48. No, this isn't JavaScript, it's Ruby. All right, so we're down to one failure. We don't have a total method. So that total, and we're going to use total dice as a model here. Copy, paste, and adapt. So total equals 0. Instead of number of dice, though, we'll do dice dot inject. So total and so we don't want options here, we want our instance variable at bonus. Begin rescue block will be here when we set bonus. awareness should be, for right now at least, a reader. I'll decide later whether to allow that to dynamically change on the fly. Fun. All right. So our basic version is passing. Let's see. All right. So we've got some straggling failures. No options sets the number of sides from the first argument. So 57, 61, and 85. And these might just as likely be bugs in my number of sides to equal 6, we're doing. Sixty-three instead of 3d6. Why you write the specs? No, that was right. 6 sides. Yeah, it's only that subject where I got it backwards. To one failure to equal 20. We set that as a d12, so that's a good catch. See here, 12. This should be 12. And that should be between 1 and 12 plus 5. Let's run that. Let's run the whole suite. .7 covered. What am I missing in my coverage? .82. So I'm missing something significant. Let's take a look at the coverage folder here. All right, so that's an aggregation. I should be able to just open that in a browser. And I can, so this gives us the simple cov HTML. We don't care about die right now because we're concerned with DiceSet. Okay, so we need some error situations. Let's do that. So similar to the die spec, we have describe error handling. And our DiceSet spec. I don't think the string flump responds to 2i. And then our dice set. Failure must be a value that responds to I, but nothing was raised. So it will let me bonus 2i. Let's specifically look at that. Make sure it was the same line there. Yeah, that is. So dice set /227. Set flump and make sure that there's not something special about flump. I mean that. Interesting. How did we get that to error out in the nerd dice spec? Let's make it a symbol. I'm okay with a string being converted to zero there without providing an error. So we'll just modify our dice set here to provide the simple flump. Or maybe I should implement it so that it responds to flump. That would be funny. But it should be an argument error. Now we're good. Let's run our whole suite here. Percent of the lines are now covered. Covered 100% in the gem are covered. We'll see how RuboCop feels about this. Five offenses. Too many lines. Branch condition size is too high. Useless assignment. You may never know whether it has been 9 minutes yet. All right, let's autocorrect what we can autocorrect. Down to 3. Useless assignment in line 41. So the RubyCop is right here. I can be far simpler here. Dice.sum die die.value plus bonus. Sure that everything still works as intended. It does. RuboCop is still not happy with that. All right, we'll let that autocorrect. So that's pretty sweet to get that iterating through your dice, sum the value, and then add the bonus. And now I think we're fine here with a parse options method. Statement. That our specs still pass. They do. Now RuboCop is happy. Make sure. I think that gives us what we need. We've got 100% coverage. We can construct these things. And then we'll add on to this and make it better in our subsequent videos. But I think this is a good first swipe at it to be happy with. Nothing major. That's all new. That's comment only. Fix in some bugs. Add in the error handling. So I think we can do a rebase against the last commit we pushed. Sure, everything's saved here. It is. We'll rebase. We'll pick and fix up, and then I'll do a git commit amend to fix the commit message. Modify the commit message. So I've got the commit message the way I want it. We will push to the remote and then ensure that our GitHub action is passing. Success, go into the project, And I know these are going to be kind of ongoing things that we're doing, but we have backlog items for them and we've got the issue. So I'm going to move these kind of initial versions of this to done. And we'll start hitting our wish list in the next episode. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.